Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to learn how to send recurring emails in Microsoft Outlook. For example, say you want to remind your team to submit their expense reports every single month, or maybe you want to send a birthday note to your mom every single year. I'm sure she would really appreciate that. This is completely free, it requires no add-ins, and also no macros. Let's find out how to do this. To set up a recurring email, log into the website outlook.com. You have to set this up on the web, but you can send your email anywhere. In the top left-hand corner, let's click on the waffle icon. See, it kind of looks like a waffle. This is also known as the app launcher, and this shows you all of your different Microsoft 365 apps. At the very bottom, let's click on the text that says All Apps, and this shows you all the different apps that you get with Microsoft 365. If we scroll down just a little bit, you'll see an option titled Power Automate, and this helps us automate all sorts of different flows. This will help us set up that recurring email. Let's click on this option. This drops us on the Power Automate homepage, and you can use Power Automate whether you have a work or school Microsoft account, or even if you have a personal Microsoft account. Right here in the center of the page, you'll see a button that says Create. Let's click on this. This now drops us on a page where we can set up our flow. If you've never used Power Automate before, you can automate all sorts of different processes. If we scroll down the page just a little bit, you'll see all sorts of sample templates that show you some of the different ways that you can use Power Automate. You can automate all sorts of different apps and services and tie them together. It's extremely powerful. If we go back up the page, to set up a recurring email, we want to set up a scheduled cloud flow. The reason why is we're going to define when and how often our email should go out. So let's click on this option right here. This now opens up a prompt, and at the very top, you can give your flow a name. Here, I'll call it Brainstorm New Cookies Reminder. At the Kevin Cookie Company, we want employees always brainstorming new cookie ideas. That's how we stay on top of the cookie industry. Down below, you can indicate when you want this flow to become active. I want it to be active immediately, so I'll leave it set to the current date. Down below, you can also indicate how often you want it to recur. Now, if I click on this drop-down list, here I have all these different options. I want to send out a weekly email, so here I'll select week, and it's currently set to 1 week. And down below, I can indicate the day of the week that I want this email to go out on. I think every Friday would be good, so let me deselect all of these other days and just leave Friday active. I think this all looks good, so down below, I'll click on Create. On this next screen, we can start building out the flow. At the very top, we can see the recurrence that we set up on the previous screen. Here, I can click on that, and here I can confirm that it runs on Friday every single week. That's exactly what I want. Up above, I could also modify that if, let's say, I want a different frequency for this email. Down below, you can also click on Show Advanced Options, and here you could configure a few other settings. For instance, you could set the time zone. Over here, you could also set the hour for when this email should go out. Now, I find that 8 a.m. tends to work the best. That's when people get to work and they check their inbox, and this way, this email will show up at the top of their inbox. That's exactly what I want. And here, you could also define the minute. Otherwise, all these settings look good, so here, I'll collapse this category. Now that we have the recurrence all set up, now we need to configure it to send out an email. Down below, let's click on the button that says New Step. And here we can now choose an operation. Here we can see all the different apps and services that we can automate. I'll click on this icon, and this expands the list of all the different connectors I can use. Just as an example, let's say instead of sending an email, you want to send out a Teams message every week. Here, you could choose Microsoft Teams, and you have all these different apps and services that you could use as well. So many different options. Of course, we want to send out a recurring email. So up above, let's type in Outlook, and this will filter the group just down to Outlook. Over here, you have Office 365 Outlook. So if you have a paid account, you could use this option. Over here, we have Outlook.com. And if you have a free or paid account, you could use this. So in this instance, I'm going to click on Outlook.com. This now opens up a list of actions that I can automate within Outlook. And here too, you have many, many different options. Of course, we want to send out an email. And here's an action for sending an email. Let's click on this option. On this screen, I can now enter in the details of my repeating email. Up above, I can specify who I want to send this email to. Well, I want this to go out to the marketing team at the Kevin Cookie Company, so I'll type in their email address. Over here, I can enter in a subject. So, hey, please submit new cookie ideas. And down below, I could also enter in the body of my message. So here, I'll enter in my message. At the very bottom, you can also expose advanced options. And when I click on this, here you can copy people on your email. You could also BCC someone, and you could even add attachments. So a few different options that you could look at. I'll hide the advanced options. I think this email is now all ready to go. So down below, I'll click on save. And look at that. Up on top, it now tells me that the flow is ready to go. That means that this flow is now active and it'll start sending out the email every single Friday at 8 a.m. They also recommend testing it. In the top right-hand corner, you'll see this icon that says test. If I click on that, that opens up a pane and here I can manually test out this flow. And here, let's click on test. On this next screen, let's click on run flow. And look at that. It looks like it successfully sent out the email. I'll click on done. Right up on top, here it lets me know that the flow ran successfully. So that means that everyone on the marketing team has now received this email. Over on the left-hand side, let's now click into My Flows. On the My Flows screen, over here, I see a list of all of my different flows, or in this case, the one repeating email that I've set up. When I hover over it, here, I can manually just run the flow. Here, I could also go back and edit it. Let's say that I want it to run every 2 weeks instead of every week. And here, if we click on the ellipsis, I have a few more options. Down here, if I no longer want to send out this repeating email, over here, I could turn it off. Back on this main list, let's click into the flow to see what additional details we get. On this next screen, I can see all of the details of this flow. And if I go down to the very bottom, here I could even see a run history. And look at that. There's my test that I just sent out a moment ago. All right. Well, hopefully this helps you save a lot of time with all of those repetitive emails that you have to send out. But please don't use this for your mom's birthday. She carried you for 9 months. The least she deserves is a phone call. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I hope to see you in the next video.